we back. It's RTTV.
What up? Gang.
And if it's your first time here, definitely won't be your last. Make sure you kill, murder, and
smash
that subscribe button. Arcane. We are on the final episode of Arcane League of Legends, the final episode of season one.
Season one, baby.
Because there's definitely going to be a season two after this. As crazy as this show has been, there's definitely going to be
I'll
a season
fight somebody
two.
If it don't, nigga.
Yeah, nah, I'll fight somebody.
On some vice shit.
We're drowning that person.
I'm going to bite the bootlegger.
Yo, he said he'll bite the bootlegger.
I'll bite the bootlegger, nigga. What? What, in the Mike Tyson, Kanye West?
But on the last episode, we saw Caitlyn and Vi went in front of the council to pretty much tell them the conundrum that is going down in the Undercity and how they were going to fix it. And they were like, listen, maybe we can negotiate. And Vi was like, no, you can't. Silco is evil. And she stormed out the meeting, but she met with Jace afterwards and they spoke about it. And she said, listen, we have to take down all of the Shimmer factories in order to save the Undercity and everything to be good. When they went up in the Shimmer factory, they saw it was being run by a whole bunch of little kids. Oh no, oh no. And we also saw the Echo and Heimerdinger link up. And he was excited about the tech that Echo had built, so they're gonna link up in the future. We also saw that Victor is going a little bit crazy because he's off the shim. He's off the shim and the hex. He's off shim hex right now. And he ends up killing, what was her name again?
Sky.
He ends up killing Sky by an accident because he's off of it. Yo, Pat.
Pat sounds like that nigga from Black Clover. The nigga in the nigga Black Clover.
I don't know why Jerry's talking. I don't know what he's saying. Why is he not talking to me?
And also, the episode ended with Jinx running up in Caitlyn's house because she's off the shim. They use the shim to bring her back to life. And now she's about to attack Caitlyn.
Back to
so
reality.
What's about to happen in the season finale? So we are at the season finale of Arcane League of Legends, season one, episode 9. The monster you created. The monster you created.
Who's that?
The monster.
Who's the monster?
Let's get into the episode.
Jinx. Not have honestly.
I don't think. Yeah.
That's like the wrong thing to say to him right now. Yeah. That he signed up for it. No, he's a kid.
Yeah, that's not true.
All right, now she's saying some good shit.
Who else said now she get to the nitty gritty?
This is a bitch.
Yeah.
Anyway, Evan.
Are they about to go head up? Head up! Head up!
Whoa, guys, this is not what we should be doing.
So you want to fight
bitch?
Her because you killed a kid?
Yeah, because you killed a kid.
This is crazy, bro.
And you killed one kid. You want to? You should want to protect more. Do it. Don't do it, Jace. Thank you.
He's like, yeah. He's like, stupid, he's bro. Like, just keep the gloves.
He knows he's
going to get his ass whooped.
Yeah, Vi was about to do him to him, bro.
So that means he's going to join me, right?
No, he's pretty much like, because I saw kids and I killed a kid, I can't do this anymore.
But he said you won't make it alone, so it means like...
Yeah, he really body that little nigga.
Oh. That was her son? You had your son? You had your son on Shimmer?
I'm gonna answer you. And that probably reinforces how she feels. Yeah, Finn, yeah. Look at him. Look at her.
I told you.
That so what you think? Nigga's cool as shit too, though.
Yeah, very cool. Yeah. I couldn't forgive myself if I didn't try. Damn, that just made me sad as fuck. It's like that shit's talking to him right now.
Yeah, I got the answers, man. Guys,
come over here, brother. Come over here.
I got you, bro.
He's the person I cared about. You. You have nobody. Nobody cared about saving the world. But together, we can do anything.
If anybody should know you can't fucking destroy that shit, it's probably you.
Yeah, with a chair.
You try to kill me? You try to kill me?
That's exactly what happened.
Yeah.
Don't look at her. Get out of here.
He's like, yo, I think she whooped my ass before you. So.
Oh. Oh, see, she came over here to get some hex tech, bro.
She needs weapons.
Damn. Now that's where she belongs.
I love how they're teasing this other person that's attacking their home, though. That killed her brother.
Oh, yeah, you know right? What I'm saying? Yeah.
Like, that's going to be the next villain.
It's like, yo, his power far exceeds ours. Like, what the hell is he doing over there? What power? Well, like, what weapons you got?
All I that thought your leg was good. The cane. Yeah, all that, and you still need the cane. I don't think his leg's good now because the spear thing kind of got angry with him.
What are you doing? He was wilding. Yo, crazy. Opposite situation. Remember, like, Victor was the one that interrupted him that I was going to jump last time. Happiness came with despair.
That was a great quote.
Silco? Yep.
He's on that hen rock.
He's on that hex rock.
Oh, they all they banded together, bro. They're tired of this shit.
Mutiny!
Y'all got me fucked up if you think Jinx ain't in the ceiling right now about to beat your asses.
Well, Jinx is supposed to be with Cupcake.
Wait, what happened?
Oh, wait. Maybe she killed them.
She killed them. She killed... Yep. Oh,
she killed Finch. Oh, I still believe in loyalty.
Oh, shit. Yeah,
what y'all think, nigga?
Oh, so she was being an op the whole time.
Silco's always calm and collective because he got one up his sleeve.
Yeah, that's what's crazy. Ass. It seemed like he didn't know, though. You see how he was breathing right there?
Nigga, he didn't.
He didn't know.
Oh! Wait, so he didn't know?
Nah, he didn't know that she was going to defend. I don't think so, at least.
Nah, like, but I think he did because he said, I still believe in loyalty.
Were you tempted?
Oh shit, Soko didn't know that.
Yeah, he didn't see that coming.
Man, you're crazy.
Whoa. Not my daughter.
And shut the fuck up. Damn. Oh. If he does that to Jinx, that's a wrap, bro. She's not gonna trust nobody.
Yeah, but I don't know if he has it in him to do that to her, yo.
Yeah, but Jinx is going crazy right now. Right now, she has Caitlyn. Those are the firelights that actually don't kill people.
That's beautiful.
This is the winning side right here, though.
Yeah. I like the look of that community, too, yo.
He's going to make Little Man into a great leader.
Poor son, now for the boy, bruh. He always respected him.
I don't know, man. You killed him, though.
Yeah, you had him killed.
Yeah, he killed him, but he still always respected him.
Oh, she's going crazy. She's already crazy and she's off shimmer right now.
Yo, those soldiers really, that's crazy how they got it. Yo, she about to go stupid in here.
Oh, because it used to be Vanda's spot.
Oh.
She's about to go stupid in here. Oh. He was playing background music for the fight scene.
Well, she about to pop that shit, yo.
It's finna be a rematch in here.
Oh, no. She's fully getting her ass whooped this time.
Woo, Shim Shima.
Shim Shima.
Shim Shima.
Finna go head down.
Up. Mm. Ooh, ooh.
Weave. Shima versus Hextech.
Ooh. Oh. Oh.
Wow, she flung her shit.
That was funny.
We back at it, baby.
Let's go. Woo! Ooh!
Oh. It's actually a projectile.
Ooh! Damn. No!
Oh, damn. Did that go through her hand, though? Like,
wow, Vi's really gonna ass whoop right now.
Shit.
Oh, my God.
Vi, you can't be coming in here asking for the smoking and your ass whooped. That's not okay.
I did not think that was gonna happen right there. I thought she was gonna fucking take her off for good.
She's definitely not Logan Paul no more. Or Jake.
Oh, oh!
Nigga, shut down the power with that shit. Fire. That's lit how they did that.
That's fire.
Move. Oh, he created a barrier. Wow. She didn't even know that shit could do that.
Now.
Punch her. Punch her while she's in the air.
Get over here.
The Logan Paul. Yeah.
Jake Paul.
Stupid. Now you ain't got no arm. Again. For the second time.
You gotta kill her now.
She's really like that. Yo, you gotta go save your girl.
She need to fix some gloves, too.
Oh!
Speaking of sis.
What a fucking...
She look crazy, yo. Let me finish my sentence, all right? With respect, I don't give a shit
what any of you think of me anymore. Ooh, yes, sir.
Like, no, hell no.
Never.
I don't give a fuck because I already did it.
Without their permission.
And she's heated because she just had a conversation with her mom and she was leaning more towards the other direction because they're trying to weaponize that shit.
Damn, she's just all over the place.
What's going on? She's gonna kill her.
She she's gone crazy though.
She's like, my sister's sick. No way, no way, no way.
No.
There's no way that's her head right there.
Nah, it can't be.
No.
Nah, it might be her hand.
No!
There's no way that's her head.
Nah, I can't believe it.
Sheesh. I'm not that crazy.
That was fire. That was like, nah, she ain't that sick. I've been souped though. Oh, she got in the wheelchair.
You would have been souped?
Nah, like that. I'm like, that would have been crazy.
Wait, oh, I was about to say, she ain't killed Silco.
We're talking.
I'm trying to see in a goal.
She got an ace. She got an ace on her sleeve, bro.
It's so cool.
I'm shooting her in the leg. I don't give a fuck. I'm shooting her. Well, she's getting hurt, bro. Like,
you talking about Caitlyn?
No.
I'm talking about.
Shanks?
Oh!
At least she knocked her off. It's all right.
Yeah, Evans. She ain't a goat.
Nah.
I love this.
Nah. Jinx is the best character on this show.
Yeah.
She is the best character on this show, bro.
Did she just shoot up this nigga Silco?
Silco picked up the gun that
Yeah.
Yeah, powder Silco put. Don't play, nigga.
Silco got clapped, son.
No, you didn't.
You got clapped, nigga. It went through the chair, bro.
It looked like Vi got clapped.
See?
No.
See?
Damn. Yes.
Wonder
yes. Yes. Dad, you heard?
Why?
He actually loved it, though.
And I believe that. Yeah. I fully believe
that. Why'd she kill him?
Because he picked up the gun.
Bro.
He never sold her out and she killed him.
I made a decision. I'm Jinx. I'm not Powder. Jinx. I'm fucking Jinx.
That's the cover of the show, too.
Yeah, that's the cover of the show. That's the exact cover of the show.
Yeah.
Wow. That's fire.
Yeah.
Jinx, you are officially part of Willpower alum.
Yeah.
You got best character. Wow. Because they were getting ready to attack them, remember?
Yeah.
We strike first. We strike first.
Yes!
Get him, Jinx! Get
him, Jinx! Wait, Mel's about to die?
Damn, wow. And her mom's is in there too.
Yeah. And she voted for peace. They all voted for peace unanimously.
Wow.
Chaos.
That was one of the illest fucking episodes.
Everything dies.
First of all, before we even say anything, I got it.
That was a great series. That was a great first series.
That was amazing.
Wow.
I feel like Nari at Drink Champs podcast.
Hold on. I don't know what just happened right now. It's actually fine.
You know that's crazy?
Fucking beautiful.
What if they survive?
Nah, niggas is dying.
Nah, bro. That's
I think Victor stays alive.
Yeah, I don't think everybody dies in that room. Somebody's going to crawl out that bitch with one arm.
Yeah. But most of them are dead.
Yeah. Especially homegirl.
Cupcake mom.
Mel took the ring off. That was like, I feel like that was a symbolization that she was going to die.
She was taking the end of her life off.
Yeah, right.
Mel didn't still go die. Everybody else got die.
But I don't think, but Jace though, them killing Jace.
I don't think Jace is going to die.
You said Jace is going to survive? Yeah. That's when he's going to go crazy. Wow. What'd y'all think of this ending though?
That was dope.
Fantastic, bro.
Great cliffhanger.
They left a lot open. Like, and the thing is, like Joel said earlier and stuff like that, they presented a foreboding enemy even outside of Pitsover in that area and stuff like that. So I was like, we still got Mel's mom. That's another person he has introduced right there. Nigga, Mel dies? Nigga, it's she's war. About to go oh, no, crazy, yeah.
She's
bro.
Going ape shit, bro.
She's going
She's
nuts,
going
bro.
Crazy. She's
she
going
might
nuts.
Just go over there just butt naked and diesel and knock niggas out, nigga. Like, bro, shit about to be
titties out and all.
He said butt naked and diesel.
Yo, honestly, this show, I think they did a great job of, like, it was an excellent season one because they left so much on the table for season two that it's like, wow, you still got me. Like, yo, we didn't see nothing with Echo and Heimerdinger. You see them just at the table talking. Now, these people, whoever's going to live here is clearly going to the bottoms and fucking everything up. Soko, I've been wanting that bitch-ass nigga to die, man. He a thought, man. Fuck him, bro. And I like that. Honestly, Jinx as a character is dope. I don't like her decisions. I think she fucking
dumb. We
don't
like all her decisions.
But at the end of the day, I think that what she did, though, like her deciding at the end, nah, fuck it. You know what? You're never going to love me how you loved me before. I'm never going to be that person. You can't love this person. Fuck it. I'm Jinx.
And that's what Vi did by letting her sister go at that moment. At one of
man,
the most
fuck
crucial moments.
Fuck out of here with that dumb
at
shit,
At the end
bro.
Of the day, if you're an older sibling, your job is to protect your younger sibling no matter what happens, no matter what they do. You're supposed to love them unconditionally. That's a moment where unconditional love, and she didn't show it. She left her sister at a vital moment, and look what happened. It caused chaos. And her sister literally said to her that, yo, you can't love me the way because I'm not, like, you left me. And the man who actually believed in her, the man who held it down, the man whose plan almost came into fruition, died like that. That's sad. And he's the one that truly loved her, believed in her when she was at her lowest, helped her. If he wasn't there, where do you think she would be, my nigga?
You know what's crazy?
Mm.
Robbie has somewhat of a point because, like, if you think about it, when Jinx was younger, it was always, oh, you're messing up, you're doing things wrong. Vi had her back, but still, the people around her was always like, she was a mess up and she was always messing up. And then for Vi to sit here and be like, you're such a Jinx, for it to come from Vi, and then you have, and then Silco comes, and no matter what you do, no matter how angry you get with him, no matter like when you, no matter how many times you stabbed him in the face with the syringe or you hung up one of his henchmen from the ceiling, he still showed that love and caring and that remorse for you.
Like,
and
loved
even
her
so, when he was on, when she was on the bridge and she was at the brink of death, he picked her up and brought her back and made sure that he was good. And even in death, he still expressed that love. He's like, listen, don't cry. Like, regardless, even though you shot me, like, I will still love you. And for her to sit here and be like, this is just how I am now. This is just how I am. Yep. And he even said, he even, what was the last thing?
He said, you're perfect.
Nah, not even, not even, not that you're perfect.
He said, I would never hand them over to you. Exactly.
He said, I would never hand them over to you. And then there was something that she remembered him saying. I think he said something like, take them down before they take us down. Hence why she pulled out the rocket launcher. And she,
well, I think she remembered
him. Yeah, she remembered that. That's what I'm saying. She remembered him saying that. So it's just like, she's going to have to get to be shitted on your whole life and have that one person that really, really cares about you and all, and just shows you nothing but love after you've just been shitted on and shitted on and shitted on, even by her, even by the people that are still his peers. But she got to a point where she's like, yo, fuck y'all, I'll beat y'all asses. But shitted on and shitted on and shitted on, it makes sense to why she chose Jinx over Powder.
Y'all niggas is hyping that shit. Shitted on, shitted on, shitted on. Vi was not shitting on her whole life.
Everybody else was
shitting on her. Everybody else was shitting on
her. They was
telling
her that she fucked up. Like, Patrick, when you fucked up as a kid, did niggas tell you you fucked up? My nigga, you fucked up.
But there's different ways. What do you mean? There's different ways to tell that you fucked up. Maybe there's a better way to go. If your son's fucking up, you ain't gonna be like, you're such a fuck up. You're just a fuck up. There's other ways to do but that, like constructive criticism.
I don't think Vander was doing that to her though. Like, it wasn't adults. Like,
well,
kids.
He wasn't going on these missions where it was Vi and the friends.
If you have more than one brother, and every time y'all did some shit, you fucked up. Your brother wouldn't be like, my nigga, Joel, my nigga.
But she
you
wasn't
be fucking
doing
up,
that
my
until
nigga.
The very end though. Yeah. She went, and that's what you created. The jinx. She told him that it wasn't a still because
she called you a jinx at the end.
It was a Vi that created jinx.
And I tried not to. And at the end of the day, yo, the most fucked up thing you ever did, you killed dad and our two brothers. Yeah. At that one moment, I might call you a piece of shit fuck nigga. Like, that's what. Oh my god, I'm broken. Fuck out of here.
That's
like,
the consequence you gotta deal with. You created a monster. All right.
No,
yo,
but it,
oh, that's
yo.
Your own personal problem. You got issues, bro.
No,
yo,
family. Yeah, I'm your older sister, nigga. Like, what are you talking about?
But to Joel's point too, to your point too, another thing that you have to put under consideration that I actually mentioned in the last reaction. Remember when she eavesdropped on Milo and Vi's conversation? The last thing she heard from that conversation was, "Yeah, she's always fucking up, right?" She didn't hear anything else. She didn't hear anything else. So in her mind, the craziness started because it's like she felt like she wasn't good enough and she was getting shit on. And then for her to go on the mission and then to do what she did because of how she felt people were treating her and how people felt about her, it just made her more crazy, which makes sense to why. And with the love that she got from Silco, it makes sense to why she chose Jinx over Powder.
And this season finale just proved that Herman Dinger was right the whole time.
The whole
time. You make
time.
A weapon like this, somebody's eventually, even if you don't want them to get it, they're going to get their hands on it and they're going to use it and look it. After
the
they even. Yeah, exactly. Like, and I know that his relationship with Little Man or Echo, whatever you want to call him, that's going to be the future of Piltover. But for now, Piltover is going to be in ruin, like you said. Mm-hmm. Mom, who looks like she's a warrior queen, right? she's there. Her daughter's there. That her daughter just passed, who she said changed her ways of even seeing the world. You know what I'm saying?
Yep, that's gone. She don't even have that you can say that kind of, what's the best way to say, barrier of stopping herself from doing violent shit.
Exactly.
That was the only thing that stopped her.
And she lost her son already, and she lost her daughter just now. So she's bringing war to Piltover.
Facts.
The Undercity and the up top side is going to be at war with each other. So I think the next season is going to be crazy.
Yeah. And there's still this unknown enemy that Mel's mother keeps talking about that's probably going to show his face too.
And we have X-Core. That's a whole other enemy that's like, I don't know what the fuck's going to happen with that, because it might evolve into a fucking a specimen. It might be a walking, breathing, fucking killer machine when by the time we come back, my nigga. I don't know.
Or
man.
Victor could be
you
that.
Know how we kept saying that?
Exactly.
You know how we kept saying that Jace is going to go crazy? I think that in season two, he is going to go crazy, and instead of destroying Hexcore, he's going to use it to his advantage and use it as a weapon. Or Mel's mom is going to try to use it as a weapon. One of the two.
I don't know why. I really don't see that nigga going crazy anymore. I feel like the opportunity for him to go crazy just went out the window.
Yeah.
Like, there was an opportunity for him to go crazy,
And he actually took a backseat of like, we actually need to do some peace, my nigga. I don't want it to get to that point, my nigga. Let's actually do this peace treaty. And that's why I think this ending was so dope. It was like, as soon as we seen the realization from the console of like, fuck it, let's have peace, they brought war to them. I love that, like that parallel right there. That just made us masterful.
Yeah, it made Vi all the more correct. See, I told y'all, stupid ass. I told y'all at that fucking council. Y'all want to go talk to the dude. You want to have this little conversation. Y'all want to try to get peace. Now, you don't talk about peace, bro. These people don't understand that
but
shit.
But it works. Nah, but it works. It works. That works.
That worked.
It worked.
Bro.
And he said, yo,
die,
you gotta
have been good, bro.
You gotta bring me. He's like.
He would have had to give Jinx, and he said he wasn't doing that.
So nah, they were going to war regardless. I was just
going to
say.
They
were
going to war, bro.
Because he was not going to give up Jinx.
He just said
that. That's true.
They was going to war, bro.
You're right.
So, and at the end of the day, she knew that. Vi knew that. Bro, yeah. There's no way you're going to get this dude. And, bro, by the way, we were giving up everything. It was like somebody coming to America like, yo, bend that ass over, nigga. And then, yo, I need give me everything for nothing. Just give me everything. My nigga, no.
Let me doggy style this country.
Yeah, I'm a dog your shit. And just give me nothing. Like, no, this is the dumbest decision ever.
And the way he
just
even
don't
said
come
it
fight
too.
Me, please. Just please don't come fight me. I'll do anything. What do you want? Here, take it. Like,
and
what the
and
fuck?
The way Jace came up to him, he's like, listen, I saw what happened if we'd go to war. We smoke you niggas.
Yeah.
That's it. Like,
yeah.
We just smoke you niggas. So you listen, this is what's gonna happen. This is what we're gonna do. I'm agreeing to terms, but listen, you're gonna bring Jinx to me. Like, yo, nigga, because if we go to war, you niggas is not gonna exist anymore. That's
bro, it. And Silko even said
shit.
It. Silko even said it. Yo, he didn't even try to negotiate with me. Like, yo, that might have been the worst negotiation I've ever seen. Imagine I know I could go there and smoke your shit, and I'm the nigga who bent over and gave you everything. What the fuck? I could go over there and smoke your whole people. Why am I giving you anything? No, bro.
Nah.
I won't go there and smoke all y'all.
Nah, but
that's my deal. I'm not going to go there and smack everybody in their face. That's what I'm going to do. And then you don't want to do that? I'm going to go there and smack everybody in the face.
That was Jason's most gangster moment, though. He really said, yo, nigga, if we go to war, we're smoking y'all.
Yeah.
Like,
we're going to be annihilated.
Yeah. Real shit. That was amazing.
Man.
One of the best first seasons of a show I've seen.
Yeah.
From top
shit.
To bottom.
Top to bottom. Score, dope. Animation. Because the animation was amazing, especially with Jinx. Jinx had one of like, my favorite moments because like all the things that would show her schizophrenic episodes. And then obviously Vi with her fighting sequences and shit. This shit's shit.
Nah, this show is a masterpiece. Like everything. I haven't seen
great.
Animation. The way they went about the animation, the way they put the score in the right places with the fight scenes, I haven't really seen that in other animated series, like Western animated series, except for this one. Like, even like the fight scene, going back to the fight scene on the bridge with Echo and Jinx, and then all like her maniac episodes where she was just going schizo and all the voices that she was hearing in her head. And how they animated that. The fight scene with Vi and Shorty with the metal arm in the bar.
Civica?
Like
something like that.
Yeah.
It's like Civica?
Something like that.
Something with an S
it's
with a V
and
an A.
Yeah, S with a V and a K. We're just going to call her SVK.
With
SVK. Like even like the cuts that they did when Vi like took the glove off. Then she took a drink. And then she took the glass and then threw it at SVK. And they started fighting. And they went out in the all-out brawl. Even the end of the fight when Jinx came up to her and she was like, good job, sis. Crank.
Or the fake where it was about to show the head.
Yeah.
She was like talking to us, like, I'm not that crazy.
Because we all was like,
yeah.
Yo!
That's good. But yeah, that joint was fire, man. That joint was fire. Thank you to the creators of Arcane League of Legends for giving us such a great season. We cannot wait till the second season. This show is fire.
For the meantime, I'll be playing League of Legends. I lied.
Jinx.
It's Jinx, bitch. And if it's your first time here, definitely won't be your last. Make sure you kill Werner and
smash
that subscribe button. I am the man, the myth, the maniac, Wilkins _ RT. It's funny how he said in the meantime, he'll be playing League of Legends. I think I'm actually going to play League of Legends after this. I've never played the game before. Joel's looking at me like, I won't, but I will. He don't know me like that.
He's got the Kingdom Hearts package, nigga. He's going to be murking this shit to that for the next 3 months.
Listen, man. Say blessed, don't stress, not my set.
Listen, man.
I think he actually is working now.
Just wear Obsidian RT. Shut up.
I feel a little warmer.
It's your boy Wells, the anime king. And I'll tell you what you are going to be playing after this is Power Rangers Battle for the Grid.
Facts. Facts.
Whoop your ass, boy.
Whoop your ass, boy. You know what I will.
Yo, what's good, man? It's your boy DC, man. Shout out to this series, man. Dope animation, dope characters, sure. great story. You're a bitch. And make sure if you're already on this channel right now, make sure you go check out all of our other shows that we've done on Netflix. Right now, we doing you. We did Squid Games. We got a lot of dope shit for you. So go check out all the rest of the channel, man.
Uh-huh. Patrick RT, baby.
Patrick is the pink ranger.
What, bitch? Nigga, so what?
And that settles it at the round table.